The things that can make me cry in this world, my mom and family members dying.
Ouch.
It's okay to cry.
It's left me feeling, why me? And it's left me feeling desperate, and it's left me feeling like I am really screwed up. This situation is just a train wreck.
Parents out there have complained at one time or another that their child won't clean their rooms or even pick up after themselves. So here at Brat Camp, we decided to see just how bad or how good the children would be at cleaning up a messy house.
I'll call on you eight times. Eight times. In April of last year, you were arrested for domestic violence, spent 5 days in jail and 12 weeks of anger management, apparently not a successful course. 8 weeks later, before you completed the 12 weeks of anger management, you were arrested for domestic violence again. And the verbal is as bad or worse, isn't it? You've called him smart-ass, dumb-ass, idiot.
I think right here. There. I love you, Molly. Night, night. Gave her lots of chances to sleep with me, but if she doesn't want to, then oh well. Excuse me, I'm burping. I'm gonna set you down on my desk now, but I gotta change.
Feel the awkwardness in that call. I mean, John was so guarded in the beginning and kind of almost on autopilot. There's three things that really stuck out to me about that. One is his guardedness. And secondly, did you hear Hayden when he said, when John said, I'm really glad that you reached out? And Hayden said, really? You are? Like he was surprised.
I'm really bad. And I didn't tell anybody.
She doesn't give me details, and so I don't know how
much to push.
I was afraid that he would come and find me. I never talked to my dad about it.
She begged me not to tell him because she was afraid he would be really angry.
We don't let our children sit on strangers' laps, regardless if it's family, friends, or an uncle. And my wife defied that, so I feel anger and resentment on that side.
I'm embarrassed to say we haven't talked about it because he's so non-emotional.
I don't know the complete facts of sort of, you know, what had happened.
He doesn't have the skills to know how to deal with it.
It's something that we've swept under the rug.
Go! 073, you know? I-30. 070. B8. B11. I-16.
I told him I thought it was ill-advised. Of course, that only hardened his resolve. I thought we'd have a little rehearsal, a little mock trial this afternoon.
Attorney Watt, I have to talk to you about John Edwards.
No, actually, no. You're not the only one with good instincts around here, Mrs. DeBaugh. I have a hunch that you're going to tell me something about my client, something about our client that I don't need to hear.
Well, I think you do. I had a dream about him last night.
I'm sure you did. But whatever you dreamt doesn't change the fact that there's a man accused of murder who needs someone to mount his defense. And speaking for myself only, I'd like to be that someone. The pay is good and the work is interesting. And if you'd like to be that someone, too, you change the subject and change it quickly. Because whatever you think about me, you should know that I'm not keen on suborning perjury. Now, John Edgeworth.
Comfort. Chance of 15 minutes remembering someone they love. Believe me, Gary. No one's going to Claire's to see a floating ghost.
Thank you.
country's national anthem to Boys and Mary Pride and the Salty Shaker. And now, it's time to introduce the home team in their orange and black uniforms from right here in Wausau, Wisconsin, USA. Please give a warm welcome to your hometown, Wisconsin, Riverside. Getting out first, the captain of the team, number 88, you know her, you love her, Heather Gelber.
Holding the flashlight, and he almost passed out because he had never seen that much blood. I am freaking out.
With no painkillers, Amanda vaginally delivers the baby with one final push.
There we go.
Started screaming and kicking and moving all around. The other guy cut the umbilical cord. I was like, shaking it slow.
You're out in public together. No one's going to read about this on some website or hear about it from Abby or Kyle. Maybe you're the one who's living in a fairy tale.
Anniversary, darling.
It's beautiful.
Donkey beanies. I'm ready for bed. All I have to do is take my medication and brush the toothies. It's I think I saw like 11:45 or after. I got in my PJs as of 9:30. Ate some Chef Boyardee, the canned stuff, you know, and yeah. So,